welcome to another edition of Roger's Radio Roundup. My name is Roger That. Yesterday in the mail, I received a box, and it was from Vintage Radio Laboratories. Let's carefully open it and see what's in it. All right, let's see what's in this box. Okay, first we have a letter. It's dated August the 4th, 2023. Dear sir, please find enclosed the PO-1956 radio kit. All right, so what is in here is a recreation of the Mike Peebles of Peebles Originals 1956 radio kit. Now that kit was itself a recreation of a kit that Mike Peebles actually built in 1956. So Vintage Radio Laboratories has recreated the recreated Mike Peebles kit. Now this letter ends in the middle of a sentence. Oh, here's page two. Blah, 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 your friend Vic. You know, Vic, if your handwriting was a little smaller, you could fit this on one piece of paper. Okay, next we have an envelope. And in the envelope are instructions on how to build the kit. They seem to be the top part of the instructions. Oh, here's another envelope. In here are the bottom part of the instructions. Now, why didn't you just fold the papers in half? Who cuts the papers in half and puts them into two envelopes? Let's start this over. In the mail, I received a box, and it was from Vintage Radio Laboratories. Let's carefully open it and see what's in it. I shall set the knife on its lowest setting. X-rayed. Box has been in a place where 99.999% of the planet can't enter. It's a collector's item. I guess that leaves out Joe Biden's garage. Okay, so we have a letter. It's dated the 4th of August, 2023. Dear Mike and Close, please find as promised the PO-1956 kit. The PO-1956 kit is a Mike Peebles Originals kit that was made to emulate a kit that he built in 1956. Apparently, Vintage Radio Laboratories has recreated the kit. Okay, we've got an envelope. And in the envelope, Mike cut these out and wrapped the batteries. They are stickers. So these are stickers to recreate batteries from 1956. And we have the instructions for the kit. Here are the cutouts for the front panel and the base. There's a picture of what the kit will look like when it's finished. When transistors were introduced in the middle 1950s, I couldn't wait to build a receiver with them. Now this is Mike Peebles talking. My first was a one transistor set with a CK722, and it was a kit I got for my birthday. So how old was Mike Peebles in 1956? Next we have something. Very, very few people have one of these. What could this be? Ah, it's a Vintage Radio Laboratory shirt. Very nice. It looks like it's really high quality. I'll be wearing this. Next, we have some, I think the panels, the front panel and the base. There's the front panel. Here's another front panel. This one's made of masonite. So I guess I get to pick which one I want to use. This is plywood. And here's the base. Wow, very nice. A very nice piece of plywood. It's been expertly cut and sanded. Nice grain to it. Electric detonator leg wires. No detonator. In lieu of 22 or 24 gauge wire for hookup. And then finally we have this box inside. This box apparently contains all the parts required to build the radio. So we'll open this next. This is what the radio will look like. And so far we've got the base and the front panel. And everything else we need should be in this box. Okay, we've got a battery holder, volume control, various resistors, a few capacitors, an RF choke, a diode, and we have this black thing is the transistor. Here's a vintage battery holder. At one time it was $2.27. You probably can't even buy this today. This is heavy enough that it's probably the variable capacitor. Now this is interesting. It has a reverse action to it. It goes counterclockwise. Now, is this going to affect the dial? No, because the dial scale is just in degrees, not in the frequency. Okay, next we have the wire for the coil. Two knobs. Here we have a crystal earplug. And a whole bunch of hardware. Here are some capacitors. Capacitor C1, 22 picofarad, 50 picofarad, and 100 picofarad. And we have the coil form. Did he put clear tape on bubble wrap? That is punishable by death. Oh, that's a nice one. Anything else? Peanuts. These are those biodegradable peanuts. You can tell because they're a little sticky. They're made out of corn. And I think if you throw them on the ground, they'll eventually dissolve. They'll probably dissolve if you get them wet. So here are all of our parts. And I suppose we should start working on the radio. I think the first thing we'll do is we'll put a protective finish of some sort on these wooden pieces, and then we'll start to assemble the radio. I've been looking over these instructions, and they're pretty bare bones, but you don't really need any instructions because you're going to glue this piece of paper, this diagram, to the base and just wire it according to the diagram. Now, it comes with a template to wrap around the coil form, and it's supposed to show you where to poke the holes in the coil form. The only problem is it doesn't fit. Now, according to the parts list, the outside diameter of the coil form is 1 5/8 inches, and that's exactly what this is. But we don't really need a template. I think we know how to poke holes in a cardboard tube. And I have an ice pick, and I have a hat pin. So there are no instructions on how to wind the coil. You have to know how to do that already. So this is not a beginner's kit. So we'll start on the coil first. If we can't make a decent coil, there's no point in building the rest of the radio. I poked some holes in the coil form. The three at the top where the wire starts, I used the hat pin. And the four on the bottom, I used the ice pick. But I think I'm going to switch to a drill bit. I'm afraid if I push this ice pick through, I'll deform the coil form. Now, this hank of wire, I think I can use easier if it's on a spool. So we'll make a spool for it. I'll put a little glue around here and put this piece on. And I'll have a spool of wire. While the glue's drying, I'll drill out the form. The coil form has soldering lugs on the outside, but also on the inside. The wire for the coil runs through the inside of the form to the inside soldering lugs. There's a tap at turn 39. When we get to that tap, we'll pull the wire through, cut it, scrape the insulation, and connect it to the inside lug. That way, we can maintain tension on the winding. I've already attached that lug to the form, so there's no reason to stop in the middle of winding the coil to do that. And when we're finished, it should make for a very nice, neat coil. Here's the completed coil, and it turned out very nice. Now, these inside soldering lugs added a level of complexity and frustration to the project that was totally unnecessary. If I were to make this coil again, I'd poke a small hole next to the outside soldering lug and bring the wire out and connect it there. Connecting the wires to the inside lugs took longer than it did to wind the whole coil.
The instructions call for half-inch screws. It also calls for a half-inch thick base. Now, Mike Peebles has half-inch screws going into a half-inch base, and they're going to be too long. I'm back from the hardware store. I bought a box of number 6 by 3/8.
crystal radios require both a long wire antenna and an earth ground in order for them to function properly. Now we can pick up an earth ground from our electrical outlet using this adapter. As far as the long wire antenna, it is exactly what it sounds like. It's a long piece of wire. Years ago, all radios needed a long wire antenna, and some people couldn't have a long wire antenna. Maybe they lived in an apartment where they had no access to the roof, or they didn't have a yard. So you could buy what was called an antenna eliminator. It plugged into your electrical wiring, and the electrical wiring in your house became your antenna. Now, I don't have an antenna eliminator, but we can make one. I'll clip onto this screwdriver with an alligator clip, and we'll insert the screwdriver into the electrical outlet. So let's fire this thing up. I can't wait to see how it works.
Before we hook up the set, I want to show you what we have here to listen to it with. This is a new old stock high impedance headset. It's priceless, not because it costs a lot, but because you can't buy one. This one probably belongs in a museum. So we'll assemble the headset and we'll baptize it with the Mike Peebles PO-1956 crystal radio.
Big test using our antenna eliminator. The coil, I gotta save the coil. Let's try this again using an actual long wire antenna. I have about 30 feet of wire wrapped around the ceiling of the garage. I also have a non-exploding pair of headphones. Okay, what I'm picking up is a lot of interference from the lights. We'll have to kill the lights. Okay, it's the middle of the day. What I'm picking up are four stations. And since you can't hear what I'm hearing, we'll connect this external audio amplifier to the set.
He said, "How so?" Now listen carefully. Because when you sin, God will react in a holy manner. And when you sin, there's chastening.
Pasażerowie startujący z Heathrow mieli nieco więcej. Lotów do Amsterdamu czy Pizy odwołane. Skala problemów jest o wiele mniejsza, ale trudności nie zniknęły. Tego ranka część maszyn i członków załóg była przecież w zupełnie innych miejscach.
What do you have to lose? According to a new report in the Journal of the American Medical Association, the use of cannabis during pregnancy is as high as 30% in some states. According to the article, many physicians are not aware of the latest data concerning...
You probably noticed there was a strong station in the middle of the dial that was overpowering the radio. But that's at my location with my antenna. Your results will be different. That station is KYW AM 1060. and it's got a 50,000 watt transmitter, and it's only about 7 miles from here. Now, Mike Peebles spent a lot of time and effort into making this into a beautiful crystal radio, and my friend Victor Rodriguez spent just as much time recreating this kit. If you would like to build your own, there's a link to the Mike Peebles website down below. I would like to say thank you to Mike Peebles, thank you Victor Rodriguez, and thank you for watching this video.
So today's a good day to look at radios. Now yesterday in the mail,